Before this funeral began, Oren, an image that I think the eyes of the world, or those certainly who will be seeking peace, would have been gratified by, a handshake between the Palestinian leader and the Prime Minister of Israel.
Undoubtedly an image that would have made President Shimon Peres smile as well, something he worked so hard to achieve. I don't know that there's too much optimism that will suddenly reignite the peace process, but Peres believed in small gestures, in talking, in communicating with one another, even in the smallest ways, to begin some kind of process. Peres always hoped, and he always had optimism, that even small gestures like that could lead to big results. So even that small handshake between Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu and Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas would have made Peres smile a bit. Now, Abbas and Peres will be forever linked by the Oslo Accords signed in 1993. Many are harshly critic of those accords these days, but Peres and Abbas as well believed in them, still believe in them, in the potential that they held, the optimism that they held 20 years ago. It was Peres who still championed and still carried on that vision. We heard Barack Obama mention the peace process multiple times. It's obvious he was trying to rekindle it, reignite it, and encourage progress there, and even he, I'm sure, would have smiled at that small handshake between Netanyahu and Abbas. Abbas also here with Saeb Erekat, another fundamental player in the Oslo Accords, that very much being remembered today at Peres' funeral.